week. If they could pull it off, then you know it would be almost unstoppable. And one of the things that they were doing, they would send their AD mid, and they said they were going to be very flexible with, they were going to be very fluid as a team, be able to move back and forth from lane to lane and constantly be moving around lanes. So it would be less so about how League of Legends for a long time now has been very structured, where you have, this is your lane, you're sitting in this lane all game. It would be more like the whole team is kind of roaming and swapping back and forth between lanes. So that's one interesting thing that they were trying to do. They were also going for that aggressive support in the mid. They were going for that roaming Taric Frog, and he was actually ready for it because he was running defensive runes and masteries, which may or may not be because of the supposed strategy leaks, which is very unusual to run those kind of summoners in that mid lane. But they would also use champions like Darius, try and snowball pretty aggressively. And I'm sure there's a number of things that they've been holding back. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see what they run with this. I'm assuming that's going to be a Shen in the jungle, though, because it gives them more opportunities to have aggressive lanes. And Blitzcrank, he's definitely aggressive enough to roam as support.
Yeah, and Blitzcrank down into bot lane. I mean, you get one hook and it's pretty much gone. And Sona could be pretty vulnerable to that. If you get the grab on Sona pre-6, it's pretty much a guaranteed kill with most ADs, and Ezreal being one of the safest and most effective ADs at the moment should be able to make quick work out of that support. Still got a lot of options open left for CLG Black, and Wings of Death, he's coming in for the sub on this game here, so we'll see what he does, if he's actually even going to be in the top lane. We may not see him, but I hope we see him in the top lane, actually.
Yeah, and right now they want to keep open their options, so I would expect maybe an Orianna pick here. Orianna's just such a strong laner. Banned? Yeah, that makes sense, because Link is very good at Orianna. So, not an Orianna pick. They have a couple of options, so they could go with like a Graves here or a Corki. Kog'Maw, definitely very interesting. I actually like that pick a lot. I've been saying that I think Kog'Maw is going to come back into play a lot recently. I thought he would be really big at the World Championships. He actually did pretty well, 7-2, mostly the EU teams, which is kind of what I was expecting. I was expecting CLG, EU, and M5 to play it, but Taipei Assassins, they also played it, and it had to be banned against them a couple of times because their Kog'Maw was so strong. So definitely a number of options here.
Yeah, but the majority of the Kog'Maw play did come from the EU teams. It was pretty effective there, and Kog'Maw is just not a champ you see all too much in the NA anymore. Kog'Maw is a champ, he needs to stay in the back line, he has great range once he hits 6, but you need to protect him. But the front line here for CLG Black is amazing. You got the Maokai, you got the Sona, you got Shen, Singed, Shen's on the other team, and Katarina to wrap everything up would be pretty convenient. You have everyone herp and derp and trying to get to the back line, and hey, there's a whole bunch of blades in your face. But Shyvana and Karthus are actually on the other end. They are both on Dignitas. So it's the Karthus pick right there on its own. It's saying, hey, I'm looking to passive farm. I'm looking to just stay in mid and get huge. Try and challenge me on this. Also considering Desire here on CLG Black.
And that's when Scar has always been at his best. They're not trying anything too risky right now, and it's going to allow them to pretty, just safely farm, get into the late game, and they're making the bet right now that they're better than CLG Black once they get into that late game. So, considering that CLG Black is still playing with a new member, that might be the case. We'll have to see how that works out. Switching to Lux last second.
I like that.
Lux is actually a pretty common mid against Karthus. That's one of Lux's matchups. Karthus really is just going to passively farm. It doesn't really matter who you are. But Lux out of that mid lane, you can provide some support to the other lanes, but the real quick burst can also take advantage of Karthus, particularly with the Maokai. That combo could work out for them.
Yeah, just the range on all of Lux's abilities, too, really just puts Karthus to shame. It's like, oh, you're throwing down laywaves. Oh, that's cute. Have a laser. Have some damage. Enjoy all of that. And Lux has been coming back. Lux has actually been starting to come back in a pretty big way there in the middle. A lot of Korean teams are picking her up too. And just the people forget, cooldowns are pretty damn good. The damage is pretty good, damn good on her too. And she provides so much team support too. You have the shields, you have the bind, a multi-champion bind if you time it right too. And again, though, this is all even more protection for the Kog'Maw in the back line.
Yeah, but while her cooldowns outside of fights are pretty strong, in fights, that's her main weakness, is the fact that you use your combo and then you kind of sit around. You don't really have anything to do. You kind of have that single target burst, and then you just kind of sit back for a second. That's always an issue with Lux in team fights. But I don't know, we'll kind of see how Link deals with her. Link is definitely one of the stronger AP mids in the game, in North America in particular. But I think the big concern for them is going to be Zuna in that bot lane. So, we'd seen Zuna did pretty well against IG, actually. So, that can kind of factor into that. But at the same time, it's, Kog'Maw and... sorry, were they playing against? Yes, they did. So Kog'Maw versus Ezreal and Blitzcrank. That's a really difficult matchup. Kog'Maw should be safe. Taking the cleanse, it's not going to help that much against Blitzcrank, but it'll help a little bit. It'll deny that exhaust, deny the taunt from Shen,
and Ignite.
Exhaust from Shyvana, the Ignite as well. But it's still going to be an issue. Zuna was the jungler. He's played more of that support jungle kind of role. And QtPie and Patoy, that's an aggressive bottom lane. They've been playing for a long time, so we'll see how he factors in.
And Kremze going to be going there in the top lane. Shyvana in the jungle. We've seen Shyvana also come back to run, right? Counter juggling, kind of on back, getting aggressive, looking to steal those buffs. And we talked about this yesterday with Maokai, too. I mean, you lose that early buff. He's not as speedy of a guy in the jungle as Shyvana. Shyvana being one of the fastest. So that could be a threat. That could be a concern. And also Shen going to the top lane. I mean, he can take taunt level one, and he'll be fine. He'll be fine.
Yeah, so we'll see what they can do. QtPie over there for Dignitas is going to be pretty aggressive. And their early game, like you said, can be pretty strong. But they'll probably play kind of passively early on. The Blitzcrank really could throw a kink for Maokai, though. We'll see what kind of, if they go for an invasion. I'm really curious, though, if it's just going to be a normal lanes or if they're going to swap. That's kind of the number one thing that I'm interested in. I'm assuming it's going to be normal lanes, or at least what we've come to expect as normal lanes. But, who knows? Who knows what Dignitas is going to be looking to do? I think they're probably passively farming, though.
They could put him in the mid for all we know. I mean, we've seen them do it before.
Right, yeah, kind of like we've been talking about. So,
yeah.
I don't know. We'll see. Kog'Maw, as the game progresses, he could just easily take over the game. But actually, he will be in kind of a vulnerable situation because of both Karthus and Shyvana. He has enough range. Kog has enough range that it shouldn't be an issue. But if Skara can get in that backline, that could be devastating. But I think really, Dignitas, they're going to look to take an early advantage and then just use Karthus to scale well throughout the game. So, for the most part, CLG Black, they need to just hold off for a little bit. Sin, she's kind of vulnerable early on. Shen will win that matchup. But, if he can take some pressure off by being aggressive, by pushing, just that constant split pushing could actually maybe slow down Dignitas a little bit and allow Kog to get farmed.
But if Singed does manage to hit the late game, though, Singed with items, when he has all that tank, all that health, all that armor, he just pops that ult, and he just becomes an unstoppable object, just looking to run around in circles. He wants to poison you. He wants to flip you. He doesn't care if he's getting hit, focused, whatever. It's very difficult to take that dude down in late game.
Yeah, no, that is tough. I mean, once he gets his items, Singed is just really annoying. It's almost impossible to kill him. We've seen Singed come back into play recently. I think people have been kind of concerned about how weak he can be early on in the game, but they're finding that they're getting deep late enough into the game that it's not that much of an issue. And the kind of concern with Singed is his mid-game, like once he gets a couple of items, he can be almost unstoppable. He's really tough to kill, but he does fall off at some point because you start to get enough AD where you can kill him, or even if he is unkillable, you can kind of ignore him at one point. His toss, though, can be really devastating for a lot of AD carries. But with the mobility AD carries that we've been seeing, it's a little bit more difficult. So it's going to be interesting. I mean, he can pull off Shyvana off of Kog. He's going to help protect Kog a little bit. They have a great team for protecting Kog with Maokai, Sona, and Singed, and Lux as well. So they can kite pretty effectively and keep Zuna alive in the back line. So their team fights should actually be really strong. Kog should be able to win those team fights if they can hold off and if they can keep the game even long enough.
And also, not to mention Singed, he does have that teleport. So if he really needs to get into those fights, if he's going to be pushing, if he's going to be looking to split push a lane, hey, there's a fight going on, we need a Singed teleport. You're there. It's easy. He can help control that fight.
And he shuts down Shen.
He does.
The split pushing against Shen. So Shen's going to be split pushing. Singed has the teleport. He can toss Shen away and then, teleport in himself if he can bait out the taunt.
Here we are, game number one, Dignitas versus CLG. You got Dignitas actually go? Are they going to look for an invade on the upper Tribrush?
Yeah, they have a couple of options. We'll see if they are actually going for that red. They might just be looking to kind of control their jungle at first before they go anywhere. But I don't know. We'll kind of see where they're looking to go. It does seem they're moving up for that top lane, though. And Singe is actually in a really dangerous position. If they actually do come onto him, they can grab him pretty quickly here. Oh, Wings of Death, man. Sitting out. He does back off just at the last second. Not quite able to get in there, but Dignitas, he was actually, I think he did get vision of them. So yeah, they did ping him off, and they will be able to back, and now here's a ward. They definitely have vision of him. So it actually opens up a couple of options for CLG Black right now.
So they know where, they know exactly where Dignitas is. They know they've been invaded. They have a whole bunch of options, though, and they could actually go for a contain. It's like, hey, you're looking to grab our Wraiths and our Red. Well, good luck getting out. You're all here. We might try and pick up a kill on this one. Walks out in front, though. Will he get the vision? You got the Leilei actually going on in the brush. But right now, CLG Black, they're still playing cautious here. They're all hugging the mid turret. Just want to make sure and edge out slowly just to make sure that no one from CLG is actually still sticking around. But looks like Dignitas is actually going to be backing off. Blitzcrank going to be going down to the bot lane.
Skara, no. I was wondering if Skara was going to go bot. It looked like he might be going for a second.
They're just toying with us at this point.
But Ezreal and Blitzcrank, they will be going for that normal bot lane, but they didn't go for the early golems. So a little bit behind there. Is Zuna actually going to pick up this blue? No, they give it to Link. So Link actually gets a nice little advantage there. I'm not really sure what the reasoning behind that is or why they decided that they wanted to give Link that as opposed to Maokai. It sets Maokai a little bit behind, but he didn't really make any efforts toward it. So, you know, Lux, as we said, we've seen Lux a number of times in international play against Karthus in that kind of matchup. So getting that level 2 maybe could allow Link to be a little bit more aggressive. Maybe just try and go for a quick kill. Try and bully him around, particularly with the level 2 gank from Maokai.
Sid actually going to be going toward that blue. Is he passing off the first blue to Lux? Or just waiting for the leash.
Yeah, just waiting for the leash.
Just waiting for the leash. Because he was like, well, if you pass off the Wraith, I mean, if you're going to pass off the blue, that'd be crazy.
And they know that Dignitas knows they're safe right now. Yep. They saw Lux move over, so they're like, oh, Lux is going to pull the blue. Well, you know, all right then. Dominate, he's already ahead of you. He walks up, he steals the red very easily.
Double buff already on the Shyvana, and Sagusid already is significantly behind after passing off that Wraith. And there is Singed up in top lane, though. He is staying relatively close to the tower. He's playing cautious, as he should be. Shyvana, though, will be returning back to her own jungle. Maokai going to be meandering on over to the red, but they had the ward up over on the camp already. They know it's already gone, so he's going to grab the Wraith, and he still has options, though. He can make a gank attempt on mid or onto top before things get a little too out of control. But they do recognize that Dominate is not, since Dominate didn't show himself top lane, he's probably back at home already. There's the grab down onto Zuna. Blitzcrank getting all of that one. There is the slow to follow up. Will there be any damage on top of it? No, there will not.
Yeah, but already some good pressure. They're able to force him back off the lane. It's going to hurt Zuna a little bit early on. Once Zuna gets to level 6 in particular, he should be okay. But, at this point, it's going to be a really dangerous lane for them. Ezreal and Sona are really in control of that lane. And Wings of Death, he really just wants to sit back and try and get his levels because Shen's just going to bully him around early on.
Yeah, you look at the creeps already. I mean, Shen's already got 10 creeps up on Singed. It's not the best of times, but still, though, Singed, he does need a few levels to get going. Once he gets a few levels in that poison farm, it becomes a little bit easier. He will naturally push the lane later on. Could be a little more vulnerable to those Shyvana ganks. And remember, he has the ghost and a teleport. He does not have the flash on him. If he's still weak, if he hasn't itemized correctly, if he hasn't built that health, that could be disastrous later on.
Yeah, but he's going to outpush Shen, like you had mentioned, that pushing potential for Singed. And that actually is going to be a really nice advantage for him in the top lane. It's going to help counter off some of Shen's map abilities because he has the teleport himself, or he could get the flank, or he could just push into the tower. So really, Wings of Death, he has all of the options here. It's kind of in his court. Like, if Crumbs is really going to sit back and farm, but if Crumbs is trying to, be aggressive at all around the map, it's up to Wings on how he wants to respond.
He just doesn't care. He's like, oh, you're going to hit me with some blades. That's cute. Here, step in my poison.
He cares. I mean, he's taking a lot of harass damage from those Vorpal Blades.
He is, but hopefully, though, that won't be the story for a while. He can always go back and grab a Doran shield or two. He can also get into that Catalyst. He can start on a Rod of Ages first, which is something a lot of Singes. Many of those dudes. That's what they like to do a lot. You got Shyvana upstanding top lane, though, but Batoy going to be exhausted. He got to shift away from Cutie Pie, recognizing that Maokai is not too far behind. He will not get the advance that he wanted. and Singed has decided to back. What's he picking up for himself? He's got the Tome, actually, so he's looking for a little bit of damage there in top lane. Interesting.
Yeah, I'm assuming he's going to go for a gold pretend build, but deciding against some of the other items, and also the Tome, it's going to allow him to clear out pretty quickly. Can Dominate take it? No. Link is able to take it. So Link, the Battle of the Wraiths, but I think it's really, I'm sure Wings of Death, he knows exactly what the AP level he needs to be as Singed, where he can just walk by, do one pass, and insta-kill a wave, and that's the real goal of getting that ability power early on. That's a really smart decision on his part.
Yep, and he also used the teleport to get back into lane so he wouldn't miss too many creep farming opportunities, and he's got a ward up there for the top river to prevent against those ganks. Good on him, nice purchase. Cutie Pie farming relatively close to his own tower, and he's actually doing a pretty good job freezing the lane down here. So Zuna is going to have a slightly rougher time to farm once he gets back. Have a flip on to the Shen here in top. The poison's still doing its magic, but very close. Shen's going to be hitting 6 soon, so he could have that global presence elsewhere on the map if he so desires. And since
Link's going for the blind bind, does he get it? He's
yes,
got the
he
kill!
Does. No, Scar flashing on over the ridge. There is the ignite. There's the first blood. Nice job on Link. And Scar, though, he is sick. He's just saving onto the ult. Good option. He knows he can't get the kill quite yet. He's just going to save that for later on.
That was
good
a great
job.
Play.
Huge on Link. Huge.
So Link, what he did there was he took advantage of the Fog of War. And right here along these paths, if you just sit right there, it seems like such a short distance. But Karthus didn't have vision, and he was able to take advantage of that. Once he walked into vision range from the minions, he knew Karthus was going to walk up. He was able to get that kill. And that single target burst of Lux is really effective against Karthus.
Top lane, you got the taunt from
Shen Gunn.
He got the ignite. Wings of Death pops the ultimate, and there's the Karthus ult from Spawn. The ignite still pop, and is it going to be enough? No, he's drinking
that
potion.
One more Vorpal Blade. He would have had it. I'm actually kind of surprised that Crumbs didn't go for that, but I think he was kind of wary that he might get tossed. He had 100. I don't think he had the mana at the time. I think it was very close to him having the mana, but I don't think he had it at the time for the toss. Yep. So I think Wings or Crumbs could have gone in for another Vorpal Blade.
Well, he popped the insane potion. He needed that extra resist in order to get away from it. He realized Karthus ult is coming. I need to bulk up. I need that extra resist as quickly as possible. And if he didn't do that, if he didn't pop the ult, he would have definitely died.
I mean, the health regen obviously saved him. But Link, all of a sudden, being aggressive. Oh, no. Backing off for a second. I was wondering if he was maybe going down bottom and be like, wow, Link. But I think he's recognizing Scar is just aggressively pushing that lane and then zoning him off. So Scar actually, manning up in this lane is taking advantage of that situation. Link was out of position, and Scar was able to zone him. So Link's falling behind. Dominate coming in as well. The dragon form over the wall. The quick kill. Psycho Sid coming in but can't get in range. So really nice play by Scar, taking advantage of Link's positioning error.
And, you know, Dominate, he's there. He's there with all the damage he needs to just fly on in, chomp chomp, and that is a dead Lux. And it's definitely what Scar needed, though, to help him swing back into this lane. That kill was going to hurt him in the long run if he didn't catch up, but fortunately enough, he did get it. He's got his his kill. He's got the assist to his credit.
Oh, he's
going to
try and steal it.
Psycho Sid, no, will not be able to get the steal on his own jungle.
Yeah, that was close. Using the saplings over there, but Dominate's able to control it. And Dignitas, they're really being very aggressive right now. They have the good ward coverage already. They're able to take advantage of that map control. And Karthus, I mean, it's just going to allow them to isolate lanes, having that Karthus help along with the Shen, so the double globals. It allows them to be very aggressive all over the map and know that they have that kind of support.
Kog'Maw is 6, though. He does have the ultimate. He does have the artillery barrage available to him, so his poke options are a little bit more plentiful at this point. But you go top lane, though, Wings of Death trying to deal with that Shen, and the health on Shen now at this point is a little bit too much to deal with. He's got the crystal and he's got the giant's belt. He could be going for a Warmog's first, which would be
a
pain in the ass, though, for Singed, though.
Well, and that's kind of the concern, is that Singed, a lot of times he can win those melee matchups as the game progresses, because he just slowly ticks you down. He can beat most bruisers. But Shen wins early on, and once Shen gets those really tanky items, like if he goes for that Warmogs, he's going to be unkillable, and Singed isn't going to be able to do enough damage. What Singed is going to do, though, is constantly push Shen into the tower. And so you see Wings of Death, he's able to go back. He's actually not missing out on much CS. He's going to miss, 3 minions maybe. A couple of minions as the minion waves kill each other in the top lane, but he's going to get back in time, and he can just constantly push Shen into the tower, and you know, take advantage of that.
But even though the tower is actually going to be hitting a few of those minions, you still have a huge lead on Crumbs, though. He's up about 20
Skara,
creatures already.
Lux and Maokai coming over. They don't go for it.
No, they will not. But I thought the Sapling was actually going to get a few in there. But there's the toy waiting in the bush. Dominate with the ultimate. Come on in. There is the cleanse to be used. Over 40 exhausts, but there's another one waiting for you. No, the ultimate will not be enough. There's the grab, though. Keep him behind. But now here comes Seigosid with the Twisted Advance. Coming on in. The tower will help take down the Ezreal. Sona goes down. Also, Dominate, though, still in pursuit. Well, not
a
anymore.
Hell of a dodge from Cutie Pie. Jumping in and then Arcane shifting over Sona's ultimate in order to get that kill. But he does go down himself. You know, he did take the turret damage. So when they tried cycling, you know, he was in the way. But Wings of Death now just killing the minions past the turret. It allows him to avoid taking that harass damage from Shen when he's killing those minions. And he can just constantly farm up. This is the strength of Singe, is once you get going, you just constantly farm. And the Hextech Revolver, just getting a little bit more ability power. He clears a little bit faster and also has that regen.
But he could be pinched. He could be pinched
very
bad here.
He's very, he basically is pinched.
Four members of Dignitas looking to close in right now on the wings. He can't flash over that wall. He doesn't have one. He's got the ghost. He's looking to pop it, but there is a little bit too much damage. You got the AoE from Karthus and the lay waste. It's just a bad time. This is a bad time. If you go into your enemy jungle without wards, you're going to have a bad time, period.
Yeah, but at the same time, four people going up top, it takes some pressure off of bottom lane, or at the very least, should you see how much damage they can get off of that. And that's kind of the concern. Blitzcrank went up top lane. It gives Cog and Sona free time to abuse Cutie Pie and free time to farm.
Yep.
And so even though, you know, Singe did die, he's still farming okay. It's only one death at this point. I mean, he doesn't want to give up too many of those. But it took a lot of pressure from Dignitas to make that kill happen. And that pressure actually evens out for them.
Now, I am still concerned about the gold, though. I mean, it is a 1.5K lead here Dignitas at the moment, which, you know, at this point in the game, it still is something significant and something that needs to be noted. One dragon will nearly negate the entire thing, but it's still something to worry about here at this point. You have to wonder, okay, who's getting underfarmed, who's not getting as much income as we'd like them to get. Wings of Death is definitely on that list. He's still behind Shen in the creeps. Maokai is a little bit behind. You know, he's only got the one assist to his name, as opposed to Shyvana has the kill and three assists. A presence in every single kill for Dignitas thus far.
Oh, they're so dangerous bottom lane, though. Maokai, he's been sitting in the brush for a while, and Lux is there as well. They do ping him off. They need to back out of there. They get the movement speed boost. Psychosid coming down. Lux, they saw him in the tri-bush, so they knew they had to back off the second they saw Maokai. They couldn't get that tower dive going, and so CLG Black, unfortunately, unsuccessful.
A little bit of indecision, a little bit of hesitation, and a lack of commitment, and not as much minion support as I think they would have. If they had another minion or two, I'm sure they would have pushed on, continue, and try and get that Twisted Advance, try and get a kill, but unfortunately it was not the case.
Partially, you know, why you want to go for such an aggressive Oracles on Maokai early on.
Yes.
Because you want to be able to control those wards. I mean, that one ward just completely denied that gank, and it was two members of their team moving out of their way. Link falling behind on farm, even though he's doing very well for himself, he still would be slightly, you know, ahead of where he was if he hadn't gone down bottom lane and been unsuccessful.
And I'm wondering if the Oracles will actually be happening soon. Dominate didn't pick one up yet. I don't think he has. He does have the wriggles, though, so he will have that extra ward coverage. He's also got a pink ward in the inventory, too. Just waiting for it. There's the taunt underneath his own tower. The ignite.
Karthus ultimate.
Crumbs.
No, a little bit too high of Is he going to go down?
And that, whoa, it's just enough. Just enough. Good math.
That was very close.
So that was really close.
Dignitas barely able to, you know, grab that. So really nice play. Knowing, you know, what their damage output is and everything. And Scar, he had hit level 11 not that long ago. So that's a major boost to his damage output. Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, huge. If they can deny Singe early on. Singe, he's been able to farm. He's been able to push onto Shen. But he is weak early in the game. So that's definitely someone that they want to take advantage of. Someone they want to abuse.
Lux going back, you know, bought an easily large rod in the last back, and also really stacking up those GP10s, Heart of Gold, Field of Stone, and the pick. So it looks like, you know, CLG Black, they're definitely going to be looking on here to build up and stock up on gold and AP there in the late game.
Yeah, it's perfect timing, though, for this dragon, because Cog was just back. They have the oracles as well. Does the blue? Oh, he does not get it, so they weren't even actually that far in it. But they get the dragon fairly easily.
There's the wall pan coming down right down on the ramp. Skara allowing the rest of the team to get away with Seigosid. He's still in pursuit. Will not get the Twisted Advance. Will not be able to close that gap. And the gold lead widens for Dignitas. Over 3K at the moment. now with that Dragon pickup, and they're looking good. They're looking healthy. You got the Rod of Ages now finished on Karthus. You had the Warmogs finished on to Shen also. You got two of the three parts of the Trinity on Ezreal. Things are looking good. Things are looking real good for Dignitas right now.
And Patoy being very aggressive on Zuna. If they can maybe get this kill, the exhaust goes down on the Cutie Pie. But the Arcane shifts in for it anyway. The ultimate is actually almost going to be enough to take it down. He wants to back off out of the damage from Bloodwater, but will he go for it a little bit late? No, just slightly unsure. He actually doesn't have it up for a little bit, but still Kog'Maw taking a little bit of damage there.
Zuna, I think, could have actually gotten the kill, followed up with the Sona ult. But you know, at this point, you don't want to risk it. It could have been, it would have been a close battle. But you know, considering that he's not, you know, not having the best of times, he's about 20 creeps behind. I think he's, you know, more content to just play the safe game, farm up, and realize, hey, we got a lot of GP tens, we got a lot of income coming our way, following our investments. We just need to sit back for a little while, farm up, get stronger.
Wings of Death just kind of toying around with him right now. The ultimate does go off from Ezreal just to force them back, and so Kog'Maw has to play very defensively here. He does lose a little bit of CS, but I don't know, we'll kind of see how he continues to farm. He's done a decent job so far, though there's a slight advantage for Cutie Pie, and Maokai sitting in the bottom lane hoping for that gank.
Still no Oracles on the Maokai, which, you know, as we mentioned before, is a little bit surprising, but he does have the move 5 boots, which... it is conflicting. Like, you usually see, you know, support jungle like this, you know, sometimes you'll see him just go straight from the move 5 into the Oracles, but he, or at the very least just one GP 10 before he gets to the combo, but he wants that income, and I think Psychos is not feeling as confident about his ganking potential here. He knows that the attempts that he's made in the past have not really played out, so I think he feels he needs that extra income.
I am curious, though, if Dignitas is looking to push down this tower, because they have Zuna in a situation where he can't really defend it. He did have to go back. Sona had to go back as well, so 17 minutes in, they can drop it pretty quickly. Yes, they are going to take that turret, so that's going to help snowball them a little bit. Already, you know, 3K ahead, that'll bump them up to 4K, and they can, you know, try and move around the map, see what kind of aggression they can get done. Kind of, you know, leaving Singed alone for a little bit now, but, you know, still, if that bot lane, if they get that bot lane pressure, it won't really matter if Singed is in a farm situation, because Dignitas is just so far ahead, they'll be able to kill him pretty quickly.
Ezreal ult to help push the lane as they now go back. Everyone on Dignitas looking to buy Skara was doing a little bit of a jig. He got a ward up there into enemy jungle, so CLG Black, their ward's spot. You got Bloodwater, though, in a bad spot. Dominate with the damage brings him down to half, but Kog'Maw is not all too he's far enough behind where he just, you know, could not really help a whole lot with that situation. There's the Oracles on to Dominate, taking out the coverage. I hope he's getting his soon. I really hope he does.
Yeah, no, it is going to be interesting to see if Psycho Sid still holds off on that. And, you know, I guess he just wants to get his farm, but the map control is definitely in Dignitas' favor. They haven't really been placing a lot of wards, and so I think that's partially going into his decision. You do see Shen and Blitzcrank, they have some wards in their inventory now, so he'll probably notice that and, you know, be a little bit more aggressive with that. But they are pushing mid, and Zuna actually coming mid, allowing Ezreal to push down bottom, so he could actually push that into tower, and Zuna will miss out on some CS, but they're probably going to be able to get this turret off of this.
Wings of Death also still farming behind tower. He's still camping out in the enemy jungle, but there you go. Skara and Dominate, the only ones here to defend here in the mid. Patoy a little bit too far behind, but that is a quick tower being grabbed up by CLG Black as they now fall back. I wonder if their pings are going down like crazy down to the tier one mid for Dignitas, though. They want a revenge tower. They want to equalize the income. It's like, oh man, we used to be so far ahead. We need to get back to where we were. And the pressure is there. They recognize that Singed is still going to be herped up and down in top jungle. They have vision on top, but there's Cutie Pie, though, with the ultimate, looking to keep the wave back. Lux laser shaving a little bit of hair off him. He's very low. He could stick around if he wants to, but it'd be a very dangerous option if he did.
I think the scariest thing for CLG Black right now, though, is how successfully Skara's been farming. Link as well has been farming, but it's really been a free farm in that mid lane, and Skara's been able to take the race as well because Maokai hasn't been there. A lot of times it can be kind of dangerous as that mid laner to go for the enemy race because you have to deal with the jungler like Maokai that's going to come in off your side, but because Dominate had the early advantage and they've been really aggressive about counter jungling, it's actually protected Skara. He hasn't really been in a situation where he had to fear for his life that much, and as a result, 220 CS, he had it about 19 minutes in, and, you know, just really successful so far.
Yeah, man, if you're going to have someone in free farm, you know, whenever you see someone play someone like Mordekaiser, your goal is 200 creeps by 20-minute mark.
I want to see if he can challenge the Froggen mark. What was the Froggen mark again? It was 430?
something like that.
I think it was like 396. So Scara, he might be looking to get that back. If he can, I mean, it's going to be a really hectic next 10 minutes if he's looking to get this. But yeah, we'll see if he can make it.
Hopefully, though, I think ideally Dignitas will want to try and end the game before that, though. But hey, if the game doesn't happen to go that far, it may happen. There's the bind go down on Scara. There's the laser to follow it up. Brought down to about a third, and there's Kog'Maw with the artillery looking, hunting, trying to find members of Dignitas if they happen to be in a stray brush. He doesn't go back the long way around. There's Patoy with the grab down on the Blood Warrior. Twisted Advance, flash over, still manages to close the gap, but Patoy in a very bad spot, and there's Dominate with the ultimate. Blood Warrior has no choice but to flash out. The ulti completely whiffs. Patoy in a bad spot, though. Will go down here. He is still igniting, but there comes the Shen ult. Twisted Advance is back up. Once again, Sid does have to flash out, and here comes Karthus. How many will we get? None.
Yeah, really close, but they're going to be able to take one, maybe two turrets off of this. I think they might get two. It's going to be very close for them. Zuna's going to try and clear out what he can. He does have that red buff, so that'll allow him to be pretty aggressive. Scara gets the slow on the Link. He can get this, the flash taunt from Crumbs, but Cutie Pie's going to go down. He does get caught with the Lux binding as they go for that kill, so that will stop their fun right there. But kind of an awkward fight for Dignitas. They were kind of just kiting around for a little bit. Patoy being extremely aggressive, knowing he had the Shen backup, and then Crumbs coming in last second when he had the opportunity. Wings not able to get the toss up there, so Crumbs was in a situation where he could join in the fray, and they could pick up a couple of kills.
Yeah, if you want to talk about someone who's having fun right now, it's Wings of Death. He just hasn't moved from top lane, hasn't quite used that teleport since that first early use to get back into lane, and he's doing a damn good job catching on up. He's farming very well. He'd managed to take out the top tier one. He's keeping the golden up for his team, and he's also providing a distraction, allowing the rest of his team to actually go pick up the dragon. So dragons will be one for one so far here, and the gold is slowly starting to equalize. It's only going to be about 3k disadvantage after that dragon is picked up here. So it's not open, free, clear win for Dignitas quite yet. CLG Black, they still have options.
I mean, I have to imagine that Wings of Death, part of him going Singed has to do with the fact that he's subbing in. And out of any champion in the top lane, Singed is an island. Like, top lane, you already say it is an island. It's kind of the opinion of it.
Yeah.
But Singed, they can play 4v4 basically around the map, and then Singed just split pushes the entire game. They don't even have to, recognize that he's part of the team. Yes. They have a team of four right now.
So you have an island, and then Singed is the lighthouse. A lonely structure.
He's a rock.
He's a rock.
He's an island. Yeah, he is the lighthouse.
He is the lighthouse.
He keeps an eye on Crumbs.
He does, and then flips
Crumbs
him on occasion.
Crumbs is a pretty heavy wave, though, so.
He is, and how much health does Crumbs have right
3,400.
Now? 3,400. Jeez. That's rough. That is rough. But then Shen, though, he's building fantastically well. You got the Warmonger already. You got two parts of the Trinity on his own. So, but Crumbs is going to be looking for that damage build with that Trinity Force. Wings here pops the ulti. He wants a little bit more damage. The top tier one does finally go down. There is the Sona ult to keep everyone still waiting for Psychos. And he backs off. I thought he was actually going to go in on that. But he does now finally have an Oracles. And like, you know what? I could go for that kill, but I also do not want to lose this Oracles that I just bought.
That is surprising, though. It's a 5v4. So that, I mean, it kind of goes to what's their team mentality right now, because they've been playing so passively for so long. They want to just get Zuna farmed. He's doing a decent job of farming. He's not that far behind Ezreal. He has a slight disadvantage, but still, it was a 4v5. Ezreal was in the mid lane. They could have maybe taken advantage of that. They maybe could have made something happen, but they decided not to engage. So pretty passive play. They just kind of want to hold off until it's really late in the game.
But we did see a lot of this passivity, though, also against IG. And back when we were casting that game, like, we were like, oh, man, are they afraid? They've got to be afraid of IG. This may be different. This may just be where they're evolving in style. Let's just be, passive and build up late.
Oh, but Wings of Death, he's in a dangerous spot. I think he's going to go down, pop the ultimate pretty shortly. It is actually on cooldown, so he drops very quickly. They pick up that kill, and we'll see what they can press off of that. So they're definitely in a situation where they want to be aggressive now. Karthus is very farmed, getting that Rabadon's. That's like the key moment. The Rabadon's and Karthus, the Warmogs on Shen, he's had that for a little bit. And Cutie Pie, he has his damage. So this is like the time when they want to press it before Kog'Maw is able to finish any items. Kog'Maw has a BF Sword and has a Zeal, but nothing complete yet. And that Lux is really dangerous because it does allow them to stall the game. Those Lux lasers, the Finale's Funken just able to pop in there and instantly clear a wave.
And not to mention that you're going to be hitting 16 on Lux pretty soon, so level 3 on that ult, the cooldown is going to go down drastically, the damage. You talk about the death cap, Lux has got one too, along with the Void Staff, actually. So just hey, you guys thought of building MR? Well, I'm gonna keep you. I'm gonna have you reconsider that purchase later on because I'm just gonna shred through it anyway.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty dangerous. The single target burst from Lux is insane, and he's definitely farming very successfully, but still doesn't quite match up with Karthus.
No, it doesn't.
280, 25 minutes in. I don't think he's going to be able to break the record. I think he's a little bit too far behind. Though, to be fair, Froggen, he had Snoopy just constantly feeding him wraiths, and then they just kind of, I don't know, let him sit around and farm for a little bit so he could get that. But, you know, we'll see how high Scar can get, and that's really dangerous to have Karthus that well farmed. His ultimate is going to be absolutely killer, particularly once Karthus finishes a Void Step. That's going to absolutely obliterate the entire team.
Yeah, and Skara, once these later team fights come on up, he's just going to be right there out in front with the AoE. All that damage is just not a good time to be next to a Karthus. It's really not going to. But, like I said before, CLG Black is not quite out of this yet. There is still, you know, a Baron in the mist.
Oh, they're not out of it in the least.
They're not.
It's a 3K gold advantage at this point in the game. They're just kind of waiting for that right fight. They're playing passively because they don't want to allow themselves to give up any disadvantages like this might be. If QDPI is able to catch out Zuna, he's not actually going to go in for it. Kind of hesitating a little bit there. Wasn't quite sure where the enemy team is. They do have some wards in the jungle, so I thought they might be able to go in for that. But maybe he wasn't, you know, that confident that he'd be able to beat Cog that successfully in the 1v1.
Toy, will we be able to get that grab? No, threading the needle between Bloodwater and Zuna will not be getting that. And you also see the transition too. Wings of Death and Crumbs have actually moved on down to the bot lane. You got the split push attempted here from Shen. If his team needs him, he can just port on over, but the teleport is also still up for Sin, so he can just go ahead, give him a flip, interrupt that, and then he can just join the rest of his team too if he gets out of the way.
It's at the point in the game when all the pressure is on the Baron, so yeah. Naturally the split pushers always tend to go to bot.
Run, Wings, run, you can do it. I believe. Farm those minions, yes.
You don't have to believe very hard because Wings is easily going to outpace Crumbs here. Though Crumbs did go with the Zeal. It allows him to chase down Wings a little bit,
yes.
Be a little bit more aggressive there. And right off the bat, Dignitas, with that Oracles, they have everything cleared out. Kog'Maw trying to get vision, recognizes they're not actually in the pit at the moment, but they're trying to bait them in, see if they can catch anyone out.
And you also you have a Null Magic Mantle also picked up there on Shen. You'd think that he'd actually go for the crystal, try and finish off that training, but he feels he needs a little bit more MR because that Lux is definitely going to be hurting. And now also finishing the lucky pick into a DFG. So if Link manages to get up close and personal, that's going to be quite a bit of damage on top of all the damage she's already doing.
And it's probably less for Lux and more for Singe, since he's going to be just laning against Singe the entire time. And he knows if the lane goes too long and Singe is just constantly, you know, gassing on him, that mm-hmm. he's going to need to have some sort of defense against that. So, it does make it a little bit more of an even lane matchup, but we'll see how he's going to counter push, because he is going to kind of struggle to keep up with Singe's pushing potential.
And Wings also grabbing the Negatron Cloak, realizing that the team fights are going to be happening pretty soon. You're going to need a little bit more defense for that upfront Karthus. And after all, you're going to be right up in there, flipping them over your head. You're going to need something.
I'm curious if they're just going to go for it, though, because Skara, he has the damage. They are going to go for it.
There is proper wars, though. The coverage is there. So CLG Black, they do know that's going to be happening. This Baron is not going to happen unknown. There's the grab. It's threading the needle once again, not getting anything off of that. Dominate is brought down to half, same thing with Matoy, and I think CLG has successfully kept them off it.
Yeah, they're just kind of holding off for a little bit. They wanted to see what they could get done, because with Karthus, they can kill it very quickly, but Lux's laser over the wall could be devastating, and they were already getting kind of low. They backed off for a second and took some damage, so they're going to hold off, get that blue for Skara, because that's actually the most dangerous thing is when you go for Baron with Karthus is that you're actually going to run out of mana usually, and when you run out of mana, that's absolutely brutal. Lux doesn't hit the binding. I thought he might grab Patoy there. That was close.
There's the binding though on Skara, coming with the laser and a shutdown on the ultimate. Even don't even get time for that. Everyone get in the ultimate, everyone will be fine. The damage reduction for Maokai is going to do great, except for Zuna, who couldn't make there in time. But this is a this was a 4v5, but correction, 4v3. Now the shed comes in a little bit late.
That's the same binding spot that we saw all over the world championships. Whenever we saw a Lux, a lot of times you could bait the Baron and then catch people as they're coming in there. It's a really dangerous spot. So they catch Karthus and then Patoy falling for it as well. But Crumbs coming in, Bloodwater goes down. I'm a QDPI, able to turn this around. Lux goes down as well, right as the ult hits, and Ezreal, he does drop, but they're able to stall off the Baron for a moment, but I think they have the damage with Kog'Maw. It's very dangerous. Diamondite, he's going to need to get up there quickly. He's going to need to try and stop, but they're actually backing off of it. They're a little bit concerned, and Crumbs really quickly saving the day for them.
It's true, yeah. Crumbs did absolutely save the day with that 20 man just to get out of there on the top of the ridge, but yeah, just right there in the middle of the pit. Let's go for that taunt. And actually, no, the Lux laser is actually still not on cooldown, so I don't think it actually ended up firing, which is a little bit of a unfortunate turn of events.
Oh, Wings has it. Is he gonna get it?
Oh, can he get out of there?
Oh, the last second taunt.
Wow. He knew he was in a bad spot. That was his only option, and unfortunately was not able to get away. But there is Zuna, though. Was the damage sufficient?
I don't know if Zuna can beat him fast enough.
Maybe. If not, at the very least, he might be able to get him after death. But there's Patoy, though, to help follow up. There's the pop-up. There's the cleanse to keep the exhaust out. But there's Scarra with the wall of pain. Psycho said, can you do something?
Oh,
anything
the
nice.
Flash
out from the grab. Very well timed. Zuna getting out like a champ.
Man, I thought Zuna was going to get that out. And actually, a lot of times at that situation, because Patoy was so close range, you want to hold on to that grab. Wait and bait out the flash, because Scarra could have gotten a little bit more damage. But just barely escaping, so nice play from Zuna. And that's allowing him to get deep into this game. He gets the Phantom Dancer, so Infinity Edge and Phantom Dancer. He has as much damage as he's ever going to need in this game, basically. You know, he'll get a Last Whisper and, you know, maybe a Bloodthirster later. But for the most part, he's really deep into his build now. And that's going to be really dangerous for Dignitas if they can't put pressure on him in the back line.
There's Link still going forward, though, by Scarra. He's in double digits right now. That is very low. It's unfortunate the combo didn't quite kill him, but it is going to be enough to keep him away. He has no choice but to back at this point, and leaving a few more options open for CLG Black. Things going down in the river right in front of the Baron. He got the split push. Once again, Wings of Death just on his own devices, on his own schedule, in his own time. Going to be pushing down the bot lane. Wondering how low that bot tier 1 actually is. I'm sure it's got to be going down soon.
Yeah, and Karthus at this point, he has about as much damage as he's going to need. I mean, he's really going to be dealing a lot with this ultimate and his AoE. The only concern is... Oh, well, that's actually a concern if Blood War is gone. The big concern for Dignitas right now is that they can, if whether or not they can get CLG Black to clump. Because CLG Black's team, Singed, he's going to split from the team. So he's going to be in the back line. Kog'Maw, he's going to be really far back with his range. They're going to kite very effectively. They're going to kind of spread out. And so it might be difficult for Scarra to actually get into the fight. He's going to be constantly chasing them, trying to, you know, jump into the middle of the team. If he ever engages on them, if he's ever able to jump into the middle of the team and get into that back line, then it's going to be really dangerous for CLG Black. Yeah. Scar is just going to have so much damage, he's going to take them down very quickly. However, it's going to be tough to get to that point. So that's kind of the concern. Dignitas, you know, even though they've been very strong for a while now, I think they've been kind of sitting back because they're not quite sure that they can force a fight, because Sona can kite, Lux can insta-kill Karthus, basically, and, you know, they can just disengage.
Yeah, and you see, too, Link is also being a very, very sneaky Lux. A lot of those blind binds are actually hitting their mark, and that's really what's been winning these team fights. You chunk someone in, you front load all that damage before they get in, recognizing, hey, we can CC you from a pretty decent range.
Teleport is down, though, and they know it. So it's a 5-minute cooldown. They know that Singed used it only about 2 minutes ago, 3 minutes ago, and they're going to be able to take this. But Toy, he's almost dropping. He does go down. The Baron actually helps, but Crumbs jumping onto Zuna. That's what they needed to happen. They needed to take down Zuna, and CLG Black is in a really dangerous spot now, losing a couple of kills. The triple kill for Karthus. Scarra, they can now grab this Baron. We'll see if they actually decide to swap lanes. So they actually might be going mid here.
That was a little bit, yeah, you had to wait for the Wings. Wings was way too far away from team, no summers. You had to wait for them to actually come on back, and it was just way too late. Zunia went down way too fast, and that is exactly what happened. Crumbs looking to push up here in the mid and dominate. Just push up the lanes, come on back, everybody heal up. Let's try for that Baron again. We won that last fight with a huge advantage. Oof, dominate, almost walking in to right at the end. But there's a blind laser from Link just trying to get something, anything. Clearing the wave at the very least, keeping Dominate a little bit more occupied.
After that last fight, you saw that Dignitas, they were actually, you would normally expect them to be in a great situation to take that Baron, but they were all kind of low, and Lux, the cooldown on Lux's ultimate is so short that Link isn't able to put enough pressure on that, because if they had gone for the Baron, they probably all would have died.
Yeah.
You know, even though it was a 4v2, Lux would just easily be able to pick off one or two of them from a distance, and then Singed would run the rest of them down. So it's interesting. You know, Dignitas, they're able to get a gold advantage, but they're not able to drive home the coffin. They're not in a situation where they can just, you know, get that game-ending you know, win, that game-ending team fight that they're looking for, and that's allowing CLG Black to continue to stall, continue to hold off until they know they're strong enough later on to just, you know, win those fights with Kog'Maw.
However, you know, actually focusing down that Kog'Maw and taking him out of the fight early, though, is a very good start.
Yeah.
You know, Zuna, he's got a while until he itemizes really into anything further. He may want to consider a Guardian Angel at this point. I mean, he already has enough of his build, you know, all the way down the line for all the damage he needs. And he recognizes, too, you know, Zuna, you're going to be, you know, Zuna and Link are going to be the two primary targets here for Dignitas. Oh, there's the pull coming on in. Link with the bind, keeping Fatoy still. There is the Sona ult, keeping Cutie Pie occupied. And there's the laser still managing to get the tail end on. He's down to about 300 health. And what was thought to be a good initiation on Dignitas, a nice grab, has now actually turned around.
Yeah, they know the teleport is down for Wings of Death, though. Once again, he uses his ultimate. Crumbs can put on that pressure in the bottom lane. Sets a slight advantage there. Blitz, if he can exchange his life for Lux, that's a big win for them. Like, Dignitas is perfectly fine with that. But Lux was able to back off. They almost got a 2-for-1 for it, and that would have been brutal. But Dignitas knows that the next fight, they're actually going to be at an advantage because of that teleport being down for another 5 minutes. And that's a really dangerous situation. So that late-game teleport could be the key to this game.
There's Zuna waiting on the side. Crumbs and Wings still actually dueling it out there in the bot jungle. You had Karthus and Ezreal there in the mid. As they do we kill the Singe or do we actually go for the Baron? Well, with the ward placement down there, they realize two fights here dominate with the Crumbs ult coming on in. 2v4 though. There's the Lux to bring Crumbs down to half. There's Zuna with all the damage, but Wall Pain keeping everybody hurt and low. Sekusid is gonna be caught there on the back end and will be taken down by Cutie Pie. Dominate very low. There's the hook down onto Zuna, dies before he ever hits the ground, but can the extra true damage get a kill? No, it will not be enough.
Yeah, but how many of them are going to stick around? They have to get out quickly because Link, he's waiting for that ultimate. 5 seconds left on the ultimate, and he does see them up in this top lane. He's coming in for a kill. He just barely doesn't get them in time.
No.
Throws off the vision. Is he going to be able to actually pick up Cutie Pie? No. He does not. So,
man.
Backs off very close. He was looking for that kill. But CLG, they're able to pick up another team fight. So, really nice play. Pulling Kog out of position, you know, with the bait, kind of, with the Shyvana and Shen, and allowing the rest of the team to get in there.
So Wings of Death still perping around bot lane. He's still looking to push. He's still looking to farm. And you talk about farm, though. I mean, he's doing pretty good for himself. And you know, I think we may actually be nearing that huge Karthus number. He's almost at 400 pre-kills on his own before even the 40-minute mark.
And he's already lost, though. He's lost the race.
Yeah. He has, though.
It really is an impressive you know, farming feat for any of them. But Froggen was by the 30-minute mark. So,
yeah.
You know, unfortunately, Skara lost that battle, but he's still incredibly fed. It's really dangerous for CLG Black right now.
So he also got the Lich Bane actually in progress there on Lux. Doesn't quite have it yet, but that's going to help the damage output immensely. You got Singe, though. He's really starting to tank up. He's really starting to beef up. He's got the Force of Nature. He's got the Ward's Meal. Looking to go into the Randuin's, even. You got Maokai. You got the Aegis. You're looking to help support. Shirelia is also almost done. But there's a lot of magic resist being built right now on to Dignitas. 1, 2, 3. Negatron cloaks, you get null magic, and also an Aegis Delph top pile on top of that. So good thing you already bought that Void Staff beforehand, Link. Good job.
Yeah, but Singe's teleport is up once again.
Yes.
That's going to help them there. But yeah, the Void Staff for both Karthus and Lux is going to be dealing so much damage. Link, he's, you know, almost finished his build, basically. So, you know, from then on, it's going to be kind of falling off a little bit as Dignitas becomes a little bit too tanky for him. That's kind of the concern, is that Lux has no sustained damage. It's all burst damage. So once people can survive the burst, Lux really quickly drops off in those fights. But we'll kind of see how they deal with it. Wings, he's comfortable in the bottom lane. He's just, you know, hanging out with Crumbs a little bit. But Crumbs is really going to be nasty in those team fights. Kog has enough damage for Crumbs, but if they can't hold him out of position, if Crumbs can get into that backline, get a taunt onto Kog'Maw, then Kog's going down.
Wings, yeah, still looking for that farm, still looking to trade. Everyone else on both teams, they're up gathering either in the mid or over right in front of Baron, just having a nice staring contest at each other. Knowing Bloodwater, he is not too far behind. Got the wards going down in the pit. Dominate still has the oracles. Clearing out the coverage. Does Maokai Psycho Sense, does he still have his? I think he does. He doesn't actually quite, no, he doesn't.
Yeah, but just barely able to get there for that sapling. I'm actually kind of surprised that Dignitas isn't a little bit more aggressive with their Baron baits. They could go for it and just, you know, try and drop Baron very quickly when CLG Black doesn't have vision. But they're constantly concerned. They don't really have vision of them right now. They don't want to allow CLG Black an opportunity where Lux can just poke them over the wall. And Crumbs just slowly winning the battle by running Singed out of mana. So he's able to just slowly, you know, control that. But they're both, you know, farming. This is a heavy farm game. They're getting really deep into their builds. So, you know, it's getting those late stage fights where the gold advantage doesn't really matter that much anymore. It's 4K, but it's really a minimal advantage.
Dominate starting off the Baron is below half. There you go. You got the Kog'Maw coming on in. Where's the laser? Does not get the steal. Dominate does manage vision. Bloodwater right there in the middle of the pit does go down. But Toy is bound inside the pit, but you will be fine. But there's a teleport coming from Wings of Death. They may be looking to clean up. No! Wings uses the teleport. Guys, we're going in. Never mind.
And that's what Dignitas wanted. That's what they've been holding off for this whole game. CLG Black not making many moves, but they're really just looking to farm and play passively. They're waiting for Dignitas to make the decisions, so they don't really have a good way of picking people off. That's kind of one of the weaknesses of their teams. If they're, you know, forcing a fight, yes, they can grab people with the Lux spine, they can grab people with Maokai, but from a distance, they don't have a way to force initiation, and because they don't want to get caught out of position, they're playing very passively right now, and that's allowing Dignitas to really be in control of this game. It's at Dignitas's tempo, and that Baron is really going to help them against the Lux because they don't have to worry about being poked down quite as much. Yes, they'll drop pretty quickly, but the Baron regen will help bring them back up.
So Goldie does extend it now to 8K following up on that dragon. Dignitas is just complete control now. With that Baron with the regen, for the next 3 minutes, just the world is completely their oyster. They can just push up here in mid, and granted, Lux has now finished that Witch Bane, a little bit more damage output, but against this threat, I don't know how much they're going to be able to pull off unless they manage to catch someone out like they did in their match against IG.
Yeah, but they can constantly clear those minion waves. That's, you know, the Lux laser right there, just insta-killing the wave, and it's on a short enough cooldown. So Lux, it's, you know, 24-second cooldown sets once every minion wave, and that's actually going to completely stall out Dignitas from being able to push. They do have Shen. Shen's pretty tanky, but he hasn't been itemizing that much into armor. He's been getting more MR because he knows he can just kind of run at Kog'Maw to try and, you know, prevent some of that physical damage. But once they get a little bit more armor, they could decide to just bully CLG Black, and I actually wouldn't be surprised if that comes to the point in the game where it's going to happen, where Dignitas, they just look to just straight out bully their way into a lane and just instantly take the turret.
Oh, Skaro, why'd you go out so far? The turret shot going to be bringing him down to about 300 health. He's got a little bit too big for himself. He got started taking those turret shots. He wanted the wall paint. He wanted the damage. But that's the thing, though. Link, the damage is not enough anymore to actually take him straight on out. But Dominate does decide to go on in. Ezreal coming on in. Sona going to keep that Dragon Lady still, but Crumbs coming on in with the shield. Goes for the back line immediately. And is actually going to be falling. No, does manage to have the... He actually, he's got a Guardian Angel. He's going to be back in the fight in just a second. There's a Karthus ult going down. Also, Sego Cid retreating back to his own tower. And Crumbs should be able to get out of this just fine. The zone, the rest of the team now following up with the damage, and that is the double kill for Skara, 4-for-3 for Dignitas on that fight.
And that's the late game Crumbs. We talked about how if Crumbs could get into the back line onto Zuna, that's going to be GG, and that's what happened. Yeah. Shyvana diving right into the back line. Shyvana has always been really common against Kog for that reason, and having the Shen ult onto her, and then Crumbs was 3v1ing them in the back that entire fight. He was able to take that. They have enough time now. They're going to be able to take the Nexus. They were waiting for just the one fight, basically. The Baron allowed them to do it, and they caught Zuna out of position. So they pick up the win. They have an impressive game. Game number one going to Dignitas over CLG Black.
Psycho Cid on the last stand. He knows he can't do a whole hell of a lot, and that is the ace. That is the game. Game one gonna be going to Dignitas. If they manage to take the next one, they're gonna be going to grand finals for this qualifier. And you know what? That was a pretty impressive play. A little bit slow play, but the W's a W. It gets you there. But we mentioned this during the game too, though. But CLG Black, they are going for that passive play. I mean, I'm wondering, though, if that is now their full-on strategy, or if it is still, like, fear carrying over from their game against IG. It's like, well, we're going up against so many heavy hitters. Like, what do? We just wait.
Yeah, and they weren't really that far behind. They just didn't want to engage a fight because they were always scared about getting caught out of position. The last fight showed what happens. You know, Shyvana with the Shen combo, they're able to instantly win the fight, Dignitas is. Mm-hmm. And so CLG Black, they were constantly concerned. They, you know, even though it was even, that one wrong fight, one misstep would lose them the game. And, you know, it kind of resulted in them forcing themselves in that situation because they waited off long enough where Dignitas could just wait until they're like, okay, when do we have the perfect situation for us? Oh, there it is. Boom, yeah. We go in. And so Dignitas takes it. Really impressive play. 420 CS for Skara at the end of the game. Everyone farming a storm. Crumbs, yep. You know, at the end, he was a monster. And, you know, that's kind of one of the issues with when you compare Shen versus Singed in the late game. Yes, Singed was constantly pushing. Yes, Singed was very tanky. He was almost unkillable in a lot of situations. But what did Singed really do in those fights? Singed just kind of ran around with his poison. They ignored him for the most part. Crumbs, on the other hand, he took out the AD carry. And that's, you know, that's what you want from your bruiser when they're farmed. And so that's, you know, kind of an issue. Shen's a little bit stronger in that late game and, you know, has the rest of the support of his team to take him down.
There you go. Good job on Skara and that 420 farm creeps every day. We will be back in just a little bit. Game number two, CLG Black versus Dignitas. If Dignitas wins this next one, they're going to the grand finals of this qualifier to face up against Mono Ferris. We'll be back in just a little bit. Yikes. Summoners, welcome on back. CLG Black and Dignitas game number 2 will be in Champs League in just a second. Just a reminder, though, we are giving away the TT Esports Knucker keyboard.